Hello, vinyl community. This is Randy. Back today with another video. Today's video is going to be a year-end video. Going to show you my best vinyl editions for 2023, my top 10 vinyl editions. So I've seen quite a few thumbnails for new videos recently for other people in the vinyl community showing their top, 10 records or 20 records, for 2023. But I haven't actually watched any of those yet because I didn't want to be influenced by anybody else. So these are all going to be my own choices, I guess. And let's see, what else can I tell you? I think usually in the past few years, I've done top 10 favorite new records for the year, records that were recorded in that year and released in that year, actually new records. I didn't get very many new records this year. I got about maybe 12 what I would call rock-oriented records that were recorded in 2023 and released in 2023. And even fewer jazz records. I think maybe six or seven jazz records. So I'm not doing a top 10 new releases for 2023 because this is about me showing everything that I have, which... I mean, they were all good and everything, so I guess I could just count those down. But I decided instead that what I would do is show my top 10 vinyl editions for the year. Because I really did pick up a lot of fantastic records this year. There were several videos in a row there where I was just showing, what I thought were a lot of fantastic records. So a lot of those were reissues and... mostly these are newer records that I bought. They're records that were new that were sealed when I bought them. They were newly reissued records from mostly the 1960s. So, I guess that's my only what I want to tell you about that. So it's going to be, it ended up not really being too much of a mixture. I really didn't choose any jazz records as one of my top 10 for the year. Not because they weren't good, but they didn't make my top 10. And also, I did not choose any compilation records. And I tell you, this year was really, this was totally the year of the compilation for me. I got a lot of fantastic compilation records. And if I had included compilations in this top 10, they probably would have been at least five of the top 10. So I didn't include compilations because that didn't seem like something I wanted to do. So these are my top 10 vinyl editions for 2023. I'm starting at the beginning with number one, Group 1850, Paradise Now. This is a band from the Netherlands. This is their second record. This is a 2013 reissue on Pseudonym Records. And this record... originally came out in 1969, and this is a psychedelic band, psych band from Holland, like I said, from 1967. This record has just been absolutely fantastic. Just really the most psychedelic sounding record that I can think of, and particularly one song, Purple Sky, the last song on side two. I think, I showed you that. So, this record, I've just kept coming back to it time after time throughout the year. I got their first record, too. But I like this one better, I think. So, number two for me is Animal Collective. Another... rule I made for myself was I was only going to have one Animal Collective in this top 10. And so that includes also, I guess you'd call them solo records by Avi Ter or Panda Bear, who were part of Animal Collective and they released albums under their own name. I got quite a few records by those two and Animal Collective this year. This one actually came out this year and it's absolutely fantastic. Isn't It Now? Time Skiffs came out in 2022, and I got that one this year, and that one's really good too. But I tell you, the main reason this one won out over Time Skiffs as at times, because it's also a two record set, but it's 45 RPM, so it's not nearly as long, and those short sides just sort of got, but the record, is, the music itself is fantastic, so the main reason is just because of the shorter sides. These are the lyrics here for this one. So one thing I've said about Animal Collective is it's kind of hard for me to understand the words, so they come in handy here in the gatefold for this one. And it came on this cool orange vinyl. Animal Collective, isn't it now? For number three, I have Jeffrey Alexander and the Heavy Litters. This is a band I just discovered towards the end of the year. I guess I got this record in about October. And I just saw this record advertised online. And mostly just the cover got my attention. And I think that was the main reason. I think they described it as being modern psychedelic rock, which is a good description of it. So Jeffrey Alexander, I guess, has been around for a while in a few different bands. I think he's sort of usually in a jam band type thing. So there's only five songs on here. And yeah, a lot of it's instrumental, but there are some vocals too. Star Power has words. Side B is just fantastic. Star Power and Aqua Noise. So yeah, Jeffrey Alexander and the Heavy Litters. This is the inner sleeve. This is also the lyrics for the songs along with the credits. I really like the fact that the inner sleeve is, you know, goes right along with the cover, the artwork on the cover. And then the record itself is on this blue vinyl. Jeffrey Alexander and the Heavy Litters. That's been just fantastic. I've never even heard of them before. Just really, really glad to get that one. Fantastic record. Yeah. Number four, The Third Mind. I think I may have indicated earlier when I showed this record for the first time, this might be my record of the year, but it's been overtaken. Well, I mean, for new releases, it's only been overtaken, I guess, by Jeffrey Alexander, which is a fantastic record. So this is a two record set. This is the second record by The Third Mind. It's one and a half sides. The third side is etched. There's one original song on here, Tall Grass. The other ones are all cover songs. And I don't really listen to too much country rock type stuff, but they do this fantastic version of Why Not Your Baby, which is a cover of a song by Gene Clark and one of the Dillards, I think, and just absolutely fantastic. So that's actually got me started to listen a little bit of country rock this year. Not too much, or I'm not sure if you call it maybe that cosmic country type stuff, or I guess Townes Van Zandt would be the main person that I've started to steal a little bit of his music because I've heard so much about him. So been pretty good so far, but this is The Third Mind, and this is a psychedelic sounding record featuring Dave Alvin. Dave Alvin, who was in the Blasters, is the guitarist here. There's another guitarist, David Emmerglick. Jesse Sykes plays acoustic guitar and sings. When I showed this record first time around, I thought Jesse Sykes was a male singing in a falsetto voice, but I learned since then that Jesse Sykes is a woman. And I still think she sounds a lot like Neil Young, though. And her voice is probably the one thing about this record that might throw some people off, might be a little bit of a drawback for some people. But I mean, it's great if you use it. It's kind of like Neil Young's voice. It takes some getting used to. I really like the old style label here on Yep Rock Records. That is a two record set. They're both on delicious black vinyl. Wow, this record has just been so great. Gandalf. Psych record, psychedelic record from 1969. This is a 2018 reissue, even though I think it is an unofficial reissue. I'm not exactly really sure what that means. I mean, it has all the Capitol and EMI stuff here on it, and they do sell it on Discogs, but they seem to be indicating that this is not an official release. But either way, it sounds great. The official releases on this are just way, way expensive. This was new when I got it. It was still sealed when I got it. It was a 2018 issue, but I just got it this year. And starts out with a couple of covers. Golden Earrings. No, sorry, one cover, Golden Earrings. And then there's another one on side one, Scarlet Ribbons. Scarlet Ribbons. I guess he's singing about seeing his daughter saying a prayer before she goes to bed, and she's praying for some scarlet ribbons. And man, I mean, it's just absolutely just trippy sounding song, and it's just a cover song, but really. Then side two starts with can you travel in the dark alone. They did a very cool cover of Nature Boy on here. So Gandalf has just been absolutely fantastic. Capitol Records for that one. I got another psychedelic record from the 1960s. Meryl Fankhauser and HMS Bounty. Things is the name of this record. This is also a psych record, but this leans more towards Sunshine Pop, I think. Some fantastic vocals on here. And I really feel like they did themselves a disservice with that album cover. It's not a very good album cover. It's mostly just brown. But yeah, this is a fantastic record. So there's 12 songs on here. And I think they're all originals. Yeah. Meryl Fankhauser. That is a Garrison reissue on black vinyl. Comes with this cool insert. Tells all about the band. They are an American band. Sort of, some of the stuff makes them look sort of like they were British or something, but they're not. They're American. One of the biggest things for me this year has been getting into, in addition to a little bit of country rock, not too much of that, but doom is what I've really listened to a lot. And Electric Wizard has been the band there that's been my favorite out of that genre. I got a Sun record. I did not include 7-inch singles. If I included 7-inch singles in this countdown, the Sun record that I got as part of the Sub Pop Singles Club would have been one. It's a fantastic record. But that one really sort of just opened my eyes to doom, and I've become such a big fan. So this is Electric Wizard. This is the record from 1998. This was just reissued. Sorry, 1997. Just reissued this year on Rise Above Records. Lyrics for the songs there. Yeah, so Electric Wizard, named after a couple Black Sabbath songs, Electric Funeral and The Wizard. And just heavy, slow doom with just a little bit of vocals, which I think I like that with doom, is mostly just having it instrumental, as instrumental as possible. For some reason, the sparkles in this record just don't show up. It's cool green vinyl, but there's sparkles in it too. I don't know why you can't. Just don't seem to be able to make those show up. Very cool looking. Very cool looking record. Two record set. All right, so my number. What are we up to here? I think we're up to number. Okay, yeah, that's right. We're counting. Yeah, we're up to number six now. Six? This is Skip Bifferty. Where the hell is that? Oh. I left Skip out of my listing. But I've got it here in my stack, so it must have been one of the top 10. So I know it was. I think I meant to have this one at number 7. So Skip Biffany is a British, another psych band from England in the late 60s. This is a very much more of a, the sunshine pop type thing. Fantastic vocals on this one. And this sort of tells most of the story of it right there. You can hear Jim back there. He has some sort of a, if it's an allergy or what, but he easily stops. After a few seconds, that Skip Biffany record also came with this cool 7-inch single. Well, it's actually, I guess you call it an EP. There's 3 songs on it. Very cool. Essex Records. What have I done here? Yeah, so that was 7. That must have been number 8. So I'm down to number 9 and 10 now. Did I get everything? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, so number 9 is going to be Kaleidoscope. Tangerine Dream by Kaleidoscope. This is another record from 1967. This is a 2018 reissue. This is on Fontana Records, and I'm pretty sure this is an official reissue on Fontana Records. It says it was the first official reissue on Fontana. Comes with the lyrics, a cool gatefold sleeve here. And the lyrics tells all about it. Right over here was this essay, which was written in 2017. Psychedelic sounding record, much more leaning towards the sunshine pop. Sunshine pop side of things. This one also came with a 7-inch single. Fontana. Nothing really to see there. Cool looking label though. Fontana's my only Fontana record. So I was glad to get that. And also, this is like black and white. And it came with an inner sleeve. Inner sleeve, which I guess is like a replica of the tape box. So number 10, my number 10 record for the year is another in the doom genre, Melvins, Lysol. I got another EP by them called Eggnog before this, which was excellent. This is a full-length album, so that's why this one won. And sort of an interesting thing about this record is that the song titles are not listed anywhere. There's about 5 or 6 songs on here, I think, and they do a cover of Flipper's Sacrifice, but it's not really credited in print on here. They just do it. So Melvins, this is a record from 1992, and this one was reissued in 2023. So it's a new reissue for the Melvins. So that is it. That is my top 10 for the year. So let's just see if I got everything here. At 10, I got the Melvins. At 9, Kaleidoscope. Number 8, Skip Biffany. Another thing about some of these albums, which I really didn't mention too much, is the absolutely fantastic album covers that some of them have. So that was 10, 9, 8, 7 is Electric Wizard. 7, 6 is Merrill Fankhauser. 5, Gandalf. 4, The Third Mind. 3, New Earth Sea, Jeffrey Alexander, and The Heavy Litters. And number 2, Animal Collective. Animal Collective, isn't it now? And my number 1 favorite vinyl edition for the year is this Group 1850, Paradise Now. Yeah. So that's it. My top 10 vinyl editions for 2023. Be interested to know what you think about those records, what you think about my choices. And yeah, I hope everybody's doing well. I hope everybody's having a happy holiday season right now. I'm just going to have a happy new year. And yeah, I think that's it. So yeah, I hope everybody's doing well. Thanks for watching.